Hi everybody, this will be my first layout video. Just wanted to give you a quick view of what my starting point will be. Today's actually benchwork day. I finally made it pick up wood to start the benchwork of the layout. I started room construction a year ago, a little less than a year ago. So finally I'm at the point now to where I can begin some of this fun stuff. So just so you know, this will be a Joliet layout. Joliet, Illinois. I was born and raised in Joliet, Illinois. There's a lot of family history here, as well as it's a pretty historic town. So I had multiple family members that worked for the EJ&E railroad. So that's pretty much going to be the center of my layout, or the focus of my layout. I guess I'll just give you a quick overview here. This is going to be a bar area. The train's actually going to come through the wall there, go around the back of the bar, which will be against that wall. Seating area will be up here. So the train's going to come around this way, over a bridge, and then back through the wall, through the same door. I installed a lock on the door, pretty important when people are over. Trains are expensive, so you don't want anybody wandering around, messing around in here if you're not here to supervise them. So, and this is going to be my main train room. Measures about 26 foot by 18 foot on that back wall over there. It's a green board construction on the walls. The outlets are about 36 inches above the ground, so they will be completely concealed underneath the train board itself. I'm almost completed with painting. I actually took a dark colored blue toward the top, blended it with a light colored blue on the bottom, and now I've taken the light colored blue and painted up in the dark blue, so you can see some type of clouds. And then I still have to go back and move some of the darker blue into the bottom, blend it. I think it looks pretty good so far. I put a carpet down. I'm going to be spending quite a bit of time down here, so I want it to be comfortable. Even though most of this will be covered with layout, I just wanted a comfortable area that I could relax in. It's actually made it real nice and warm down here. So, this is basically, I'm working on my track layout, pretty much how it's going to be. Still in the very early in the track planning phase, so plan on using the Atlas 3-rail track. This is my first scratch build project, which if you've been looking at my blog at all, the link is posted on my YouTube page. This is the first scale, my first scratch build project I've ever done, actually, and I'm about a year into this as well. It's the Joliet Union Station. It was built in 1912, so it actually turns 100 years old this year. So right now I just have it standing up. I just wanted to get an idea how big it's going to be. It's actually pretty massive. It's about 3.5 foot by 3.5 foot base it'll need for the trains. And one goal I had in my layout is I want to recreate scenes. So my goal is not really to have pick as many trains in as I can. It's more to create realistic scenes of Joliet in the early 1900s as well as today. I wanted to have some buildings and bridges interchangeable on the layout so I could run steamers and make it look like it's in the 1920s, or run some diesels and make it look like it's in the 70s or today. An important part of the Joliet layout is the diamonds. I haven't exactly completed the track plan here yet, but the diamonds are going to be right here. There's two right now. There's going to be four once I get it going. Probably going to stick with four. So the track's going to go, that would be westbound toward the Des Plaines River, which will run basically into where that cove is back there. Now, if you've never heard of Joliet, it's in Illinois, about 40 miles south of Chicago. It's pretty much most famous for the Illinois State Penitentiary that's here. That was built in the late 1800s, and they actually filmed the Blues Brothers opening scenes there. John Belushi played Joliet Jake. It's probably most famous for that. When Abraham Lincoln was assassinated, his body actually came through Joliet in the middle of the night, and it came right through and headed down toward Lockport, and that was on the Alton Line. Joliet has a very rich train history, and it started. Joliet was first known for its businesses as quarries, and then it became a big steel city, and it gave plenty of life to the railroads around this industry. And it's actually still going strong today. CN just bought out EJ&E a few years ago, so it was kind of sad to see the EJ&E go away, but there's still a strong rail history in Joliet today. One design aspect I wanted to show you in the basement, there's actually a window here, and my father-in-law, who's pretty much an expert carpenter, figured out a way to enclose the window. So it's actually wood, which is held together to the wall by Velcro. So it's kind of hard to see, which is good. If you stand back, I don't want you to know that there's a window there. So I could take that down if I need to. It's just held up by Velcro. Pretty ingenious idea on his part. So some obstacles I have in the room, of course. There's got to be a pole right in the middle of the room. And I have an ejector pump, water heater, and a furnace. So I'm going to come up with some creative ways to hide all that in the background. Basically, I want to have a town area in the middle here. And that's going to be removable. So when large amounts of people come over, I can remove this middle area of the layout and people can walk around in the middle. This will be basically the main downtown area. So that's about it for first video of the layout. I hope to bring you some good videos in the future. I've really enjoyed everyone else's videos and gives me great ideas looking at other people's layouts. So I thought I would do my part and try to post some videos of my layout progress to share with all of you. So I hope you enjoy and I hope to see you back in the future. Thanks.